Michael Aubertin was versatile, as his involvement in various aspects of local culture proves. Apart from dabbling in prose and poetry, he was the director of culture for 3 years and worked as APCD with the Peace Corps. He was interviewed by the BBC in relation to his historical novel, Negmaon Freedom Fighter, which addresses slavery and oppression as well as gender issues. Former director of the FRC, Hilary Laforce, recalls the icon's active days.
"And where are you off to?" the voice demanded, causing Emmanuel to stop with a jolt. It was Jacques, the overseer. He carried a whip wherever he went and was not afraid to use it. "Monsieur Ligier told me to tell Golan that he must be with Madame and I today," she said, annoyed at the slight tremor and higher timbre of a voice that betrayed her anxiety. "Madame and I?" Jacques said mockingly. "You're putting on airs already? You've only spent one night up there and it's Madame and I?"
Once again, another cultural icon has passed. And only last week, the 11th of August, we were celebrating 10 years of the passing of Cecin Descartes, as in the Queen of Culture, another powerful cultural icon. And it appears as if there is some kind of, as we say, complot for those cultural icons to depart one after the other. But if Mike, I knew him, he's my schoolmate. In fact, when I knew him, his name was Michael Quinlan. He's now called Michael Aubertin. And this gentleman, we have been friends for all those years. In fact, during my stint at the Folk Research Center, by virtue of his expertise in the brigands, he actually wrote a book on the Negmaon. And he used to come out there when we had programs for school children, we call cultural education programs, twice to the year. At one time, it was actually done post-common entrance and then during junior choir.
Mighty Mighty, as he was known when he took a shot at performing in the Calypso Arena and won the title of King back in 1979.
As you rightly said, he was an accomplished Calypsonian. One of his famous songs that ended up making Better Than the Dead. Also, he won the Independence Calypso Crown of St. Lucia. Some people would not remember that. And he also won a BBC short story competition. He made us proud as St. Lucia after several other, persons who attempted to win that prize. And so Mike Aubertin, unfortunately, I don't think that he was honored by the country. And I think they should be consider honoring him posthumously. There is no reason why we shouldn't look at that. And I'm hoping that the powers that be. In fact, as you know, we normally have to make recommendations to the committee that sees about this, and I think we can arrange to do that to ensure that he's recognized, appropriately. Yes, definitely he'll be greatly missed, and I wish to send condolences, especially to his brother, who's Max Stevens Aubertin, another accomplished Calypsonian and cultural icon in his own right. His wife especially, his wife Rose, and the rest of his family.
Michael Aubertin was 72 years old and leaves to mourn his wife and 3 children. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.